Hello to everyone. My name is Dmitry and I'm a field worker of First Things Foundation here in Mozambique, Corrane town. I'm excited to present you our first impresario ever, Sister Salome. She's a Catholic nun and we met her accidentally, like most of the things happens with us here so far. We were having troubles to find a room to teach English class for secondary school, and she kind of knew about that from someone and offered us a room, one of room of her congregation that is right next to secondary school. So that was a very big help. And a few days later, I was in Pururu community that is quite distant from Corrane, just exploring around. And I was very surprised how little there people speak Portuguese. And then I met her and we started to talk, and she told me that she's actually there to give lessons to children on some basic subjects like Portuguese and math, because children there are left without any basic education, and without, in Mozambican Portuguese speaking society, without any prosper future. So now I will pass my word to Irma Salome, Sister Salome, so she will explain you her vision and her project about this school.
Bom dia, Irma Salome.
Bom dia, Jacob.
Como está?
Estou bem.
Pode fazer uma apresentação para nós?
Sim, eu sou a irmã Salomé, missionária claretiana, vivo em Moçambique 12 anos e moro no norte de Moçambique, no 16 de Nampula, na localidade de Corrane.
Então, pode falar sobre este projeto que você quer fazer em colaboração com o First Things?
Sim, o projeto da construção de uma escola primária, e que queremos fazer a colaboração com vocês, nos ajudar a construir uma boa escola durável para as crianças, para que se desenvolvam bem. Sim.
Por que precisamos esta escola aqui?
Sim, precisamos de escola primeiramente no bairro. Encontramos muitas crianças que não vão na escola por causa da distância da outra escola do outro bairro. Era a primeira. E a segunda é que tinha muitas crianças. E as casas, a sala de classe que nós fizemos ano passado para as aulas, são a sala de palha e de matope. Então, quando vem vento, chuva, cai. E cada ano temos que recomeçar a construção. E isso não dá certo e não ajuda no processo de criança. Por isso que pedimos e gostaríamos que ajudarmos nós a construir uma boa escola. E para que a criança aprenda a ler, escrever e construir um futuro livre e alegre.
So actually, Sister Salome sees the school as an exemplary center of primary education to where people would be happy to send their children. Right now, it's just we have two classes, 80 children in each class, and one teacher from the government who was sent there on Sister Salome's request. But next year is going to be two more classes and probably third year, two more. So for that needs to be built infrastructure, because right now it's just a mud hut. The thing that is going to be wiped out by the first cyclone, thing that happens here on occasion. So Pururu school really needs a building, a solid one. And in the future, buildings. We were engaged in the project with Sister Salome in January, and we were trying to help her with anything we can right now. We found an architect. We participated in a few meetings with local officials and community leaders, and they all agreed to help us with anything that is in their might. And also, we have all the documents. Sister Salome got legal documents to have permission to build the school and exactly where it should be built according to the government. So right now, actually, we are facing the only issue, and it is financing. We need to fundraise around $8,000 to build the first two classrooms, and the cost of the whole project would be close to $30,000. Yeah, so we really need to reach out to every possible donors in Mozambique or abroad, and with the help of God, we're going to make it. Thank you for watching, and I will keep you updated on anything every month.